Hey Asher, are you ready for some fun on My Shot with the tuba? This has got a really fun part. I'm excited for you. I'm gonna play through bits and pieces, but before you watch this, make sure you watch the rhythm video. That'll help with a couple of things. I wanna focus more on just tuba specific stuff for this video, okay? So first thing, whenever you go to a B natural, you see that quite often goes from B to C. That B natural you need to make sure is low enough in pitch. So on your tuba at home, you'll want to make sure the second valve is pulled out a little bit. And also that fourth valve slide. You find the tubing where the fourth valve is and pull that out. If you're using one of the smaller tubas at home, so what I've done is pull out this second valve and this third valve, okay, to make sure that I get low enough in pitch for that B natural. So here's a B flat. So you want to get that B natural right where it should go, and then B natural to C. Should hear that pitch change. A lot of times B natural will be so sharp that it's basically a C. So you want to watch for that, listen, make sure you're aware of that. So right from the get-go, you know, that B natural to C happening a lot. Like here's the beginning. One, two, three. Okay, so that's a really cool part you have there. Especially that two and three and four and a one. You want to dig into that and a one, the C, D, E. Okay. Up to the F sharp. So you have that. Next thing, let's look at measure 7 and 8. Notice how the end goes do dot do dot dot. So you have long, short, long, short. Okay, F sharp to D. Two and three. Okay, there's another B natural there. We need to hear those pitch changes right where they're supposed to be. Let's look at measure 20, where you go from a low A to an F sharp. A, F sharp, G. Okay. So in time, measure 20 is going to sound like this. One, two, three. Two and three. Okay, do that. Two, three, four. So you can work through that little by little, slow it down. Two and three. That's how that goes there. Let's take a look at some stuff closer to the end. I'm going to look at 52. The whole band does this. They go one and a e for a lit one. Okay, so you have that for a lit one right on four. One e and a and e for a lit one. Okay, do that again. Two, three, and four. One, and for a lit one. So I put the metronome on and clap that rhythm slowly. This is 52. It's going to go like this. Two, three, and four. One, E, and A, and E, for a lit one. Two, three, and four. One, E, and A, and E, for a lit one. Now, playing that, it's going to sound like this. So that's at 53. Up to speed, that's going to be like this. Okay, so that's a little quicker. I'm going to measure 55. Crescendo up through that. I'm gonna go up measure 60. I'm gonna play 60 to the end now. Listen. 2, 3, 4. Lots of cool stuff in there. I played the lower octave at measures 66 and 67. I think you can definitely aim for that. So you start on a D and then go B flat, G, F sharp. Okay, just relax downward. Then you go up to the other F sharp. If you don't want to do the lower octave, it'll go like this. Okay, let's go ahead and play through the whole song so you can hear just what the tuba part sounds like for my shot. Here we go. Okay, it's a really cool part. I'm excited for you. Happy playing at home.